Good morning, students. Today I am here to explain your next chapter, that is chapter 3, soil resources. But before starting this new lesson, I want to say something about the previous one. First of all, if you think that Miss will again discuss this chapter in the school after reopening the school, you are wrong, because I told yesterday I will only explain your doubt. I will not explain that chapter again. Clear? And one more important thing, the homework, which one I had given you. You have to do that one at home, which one I will check after reopening the school. And now, the same thing is applicable for our new chapter also. And one more thing. Yes, from the last chapter, Climate of India, only and only one topic is left. That is one calculation part. That calculation part we will practice after reopening the school. That is definitely we will do after that. But except calculation part, I will not explain anything. Only your doubts I will clear. Is it clear? Now, move on our new chapter. That is soil resource. It is our third chapter. And these are the topics of this chapter. 1 to 9, I have mentioned all the topics. And you please note down, you please write down all the topics in your copy. Topic number 1, we will know about the soil. What is soil? Its definition. Then we will know its importance. I think many of you know, all of you know actually. Formation of soil. Factors affecting the soil formation. And there are 4 factors. I have mentioned, I will explain. Next, soil profile. Yes, which can be divided into 4 categories. I have mentioned. Now number 6, types of soil. The most important topic. The most important topic, types of soil. In detail, I will discuss this one. So, I am giving here star mark. Okay, the most important topic of this chapter. And number 7, soil erosion. What is the meaning of soil erosion? Then we will know types of soil erosion. There are 3 types of soil erosion and it has subdivision also. I will discuss. And the last one, soil conservation. I know this point also very, this topic also very clear for you. All of you know the some methods through which we can conserve the soil. So these are the 9 topics. So now, what is soil? First topic. Soil is a loose material. It is located where? On the earth's crust. And it consists 2 important things. 2 important materials. 1, rock particles. And 2, humus. These are the 2 main things which are present in the soil. But except these 2, water and air also found in the soil. Now, importance of soil. It is very important, all of you know. We derived almost everything that we need in our life. We get it from soil. Main thing, all of you know, food. We are getting food from here because food can produce on this surface. These are the main importance. Second one, formation of soil. Yes, only one and one process is there, and that is weathering. Weathering is a process through which soil can form. But soil formed due to weathering from where? From a rock. Weathering takes place on a rock. And from a rock, we are getting soil. Next one, factors affecting soil formation. What are the factors affect the soil formation? Factor number 1, climate. Yes, climate means the 2 important thing of climate is temperature. And another one is rainfall. So you know these 2, heavy temperature, heavy rainfall,
determine the soil quality. Because due to heavy temperature, due to heavy rainfall, sometimes humus can wash away. So due to these two factors, we are getting different soils. Parent rock, yes. Parent rock, just now I said, soil formed from rock. And rock consists different minerals. So, soil formed from rock. And different rock consists different minerals. And different minerals are found in different types of soil. That's why parent rock is another factor. Third one is relief. Means topography. Means, we know the relief throughout the world, in our country, whatever you can take as an example, not same. Somewhere height is high, somewhere height is low. Generally, we have seen where the slope is very steep, there are thin soil produced. Where slope is gentle, there are thick soil, comparatively thick soil formed. And all of you know Gangetic plain, where thick alluvium soil formed because it's a plain. So according to relief, soil developed. And the time, yes. The formation of soil is a very time-taking process. It formed due to weathering, but it takes lots of time. Lots of time to form. So, time is another factor to form the soil. Our next topic, that is profile. Soil is a very thin layer, we know. But this thin layer can divide it into four different layers. So from top to bottom, this sequence together called soil profile. And these four layers are topsoil, subsoil, weathered rock, bedrock. And these four layers, each layer called separately called horizon. Topsoil, one horizon, subsoil, another horizon. Like this way we have four horizons. Out of these four horizons, these two are very negligible because these two layers consist rock particles very large in size and these are not important to grow plants. These two layers are not so important, but these two layers are very important, especially this one, topsoil. Topsoil consists very fine rock particles and huge humus, which is important for plant. And in subsoil, the size of rock particles greater than topsoil and humus quantity is less than the topsoil. So, two important layers or two important horizons of a soil profile are topsoil and subsoil. And these two are also present. Now, the types of soil, I said, I will discuss it later in a detailed way because most important topic. Now, the soil erosion. Yes, what do you mean by soil erosion? Soil erosion means the removal of topsoil. Yes, just now I said the topsoil. So the removal of topsoil due to some agents of nature. That is called soil erosion. And on the basis of that agents, we are getting different types of soil erosion. And the types are shore erosion, wind erosion and erosion by running water. So how many agents we can see? See, wind and running water. These two, first two, shore erosion and wind erosion, these two are important but applicable in a particular place. This one we can see in a shore area, means where sea and land meet, only that area, due to waves, sea waves. And wind erosion applicable, or we can see where, in a desert area. Or the area which is free from vegetation. But this erosion, running water, this one we can see or applicable in different area. On the basis of that, we are getting four subdivisions of this running water erosion. One is sheet erosion, gully, stream and rill. Sorry, here stream bank erosion. And the last one, rill erosion. First three is a kind of erosion, almost same kind. Means you have the idea about the river. River is the larger form of water body. Larger channel, not form of water body. It's a wrong
It's a river is a very large water channel. And after the river, size wise, we are getting stream, gully and rill. They are the small channel of water bodies. And when they flow from originating point to draining point, surface gets eroded. And that's why we are getting these three different subdivisions. And this one takes place due to heavy rain over a large area. So an area suppose free from vegetation and heavy rain takes place. So maximum amount of soil gets eroded due to heavy rain. And that erosion is called sheet erosion. Done. And the last one is soil conservation. Yes, some methods we have to follow. We should follow because soil is very important. Important for us, we know. And very important thing to know that it takes time. Huge time, thousands of years to form. But very quickly it gets washed away. That's why we have to conserve it. And for that reason, some methods we can follow. And the methods are, first one, afforestation. Means planting more trees. Because we know roots can bind the soil. Plants can protect or can reduce the speed of wind. Next, contour farming. Or terrace farming. These are the some type of farming method which are applicable in hilly areas, slopy areas. Because slopy land means more erosion. Next few more points we can say, that is reduce overgrazing. Overgrazing is, you know the meaning of overgrazing. So we should reduce that overgrazing one. We should check the overgrazing. Another method. One more method as a food we can say, it is applicable in the river area, like construction of dam, which can reduce the soil erosion. And one more point I can say, that was planting of shelter bells. Planting of shelter bells is applicable in desert area, or you can say the area which is free from vegetation. There we can plant more and more trees in a proper way. That is called planting of shelter bells. So these are the few methods which we follow as a conservation method of soil. Now the most important topic of this chapter, which one I already mentioned, topic 6, types of soil. Now we are going to discuss types of soil in India, which can be divided into 4 categories, mainly divided into 4 types. I have mentioned that word. And the 4 types are alluvial soil, black soil, red soil, laterite soil. First, alluvial soil, the most fertile soil of India. And the quantity wise very high. We can say the 40% area of our country is covered by this soil. This soil again divided into 2 types on the basis of location. Means alluvial soil is located in North India. Alluvial soil is also located in South India. That's why we are getting 2 types of alluvial soil. And all of you know, comparatively, this one means the alluvial soil in North India more fertile. And this fertile soil again divided into 2 categories. One is called bhangar, another is called khadar. This division also we are getting from location. Location means, we know the alluvial soil of North India developed due to work of Ganga. Ganga river has originated in Himalayas region, Gangotri glacier, from there to Bay of Bengal. It's a huge distance which can be divided into 2 locations. One upper Himalayas, another is lower Himalayas. So in upper Himalayas, Bhangar we can see. And the lower Himalayas, Khadar we can see. Both are very fertile, but if we compare, Khadar is more fertile. Khadar is more fertile. And their minerals, their constituents differ. That one I will discuss later. But Bhangar, Khadar, both are alluvial soil found in North India. And comparatively, Khadar is more fertile than Bhangar. Next type, black soil. We know that our Deccan trap area, our plateau area is covered by this soil. Almost 16% area of our country is covered by this soil. And this soil developed due to work of
weathering from lava rock. Black soil develops from lava rock. And the red soil, 10% area is covered by this soil, red soil. And it is called red because of its color. It's color red. Why? Because the presence of iron oxide. Huge quantity of iron is located in this soil. And the last one, laterite soil. Laterite soil, actually it has one more meaning. Brick. It's a Latin word. It means brick. It developed due to rainfall, heavy rainfall. This rainfall, that process has one more name, leaching. Yes, we can say laterite soil developed due to the process of leaching. What is leaching? Leaching actually takes place when heavy rainfall takes place. And due to that heavy rainfall, the humus, the nutrients of topsoil can remove. And we are getting this laterite soil. That's why here humus, maximum humus removed. That's why we can say laterite soil is not so fertile like alluvial or black soil. So these are the four types of soil. These four types of soil, we have to prepare some information about these four types of soil. What information? I have given one table here. One, name or types, which one already I have mentioned. Another, characteristics. Another, location. And another, crops grown in this particular type of soil. And it is your homework. You first prepare this table. Then if is there any doubt, I will clear about. See, names I mentioned because in India there are four types of soil. You have to find out their location. And you have to find out the crops names, particular crops which grown in particular this soil. Means two examples of crops which grown in alluvial, two examples of crops grown in black soil, two examples of crops grown in red soil, like that way. And what about the characteristics? Yes, if you follow the book, textbook, there are many characteristics given. And every year I can see the student make mistake when they write their characteristics. Suppose there are many characteristics, many minerals information because rocks develop from, because soil develops from rocks, rocks contain mineral, I said. So the minerals name, the characteristics of alluvial, black soil, red soil, when they write during exam, completely wrong they write. In place of alluvial, they write the black soil characteristics. Place of black soil, they write different answer. That's why out of many characteristics in your book, specifically I have mentioned, you prepared this one. Otherwise, all are correct. But these three are specific one, very appropriate one. That's why the characteristics of alluvial soil, you try to prepare point 1, 3, 4. Characteristics of black soil, you try to prepare 2, 4, 6. Characteristics of red soil, you try to prepare 3, 4, 5. And the laterite soil, characteristics of laterite soil, sorry, first one was red. Now laterite soil, 1, 4 and 5. These three characteristics you prepare for each soil. Okay, so now few more homeworks are left, which one I am going to give now. Okay. Now the homework part, which one I am going to give, because our chapter soil resources completed almost. Homework, already I have mentioned one table I had given in completed, it was in completed table. I mentioned types of soil, their characteristics, which point you will prepare, but two columns were left, which one you have to fill up. So you have to make whole table in your copy. That is one homework. And your next homework, you have to find out the meaning of these terms, A to Z. Few terms I said, few terms I didn't say. You please try to find out the meaning, otherwise for your doubt, I will be there, I said already. First, soil, you have to define it. Soil erosion, you have to define it. Soil conservation, very three common words I explained already. These two, pedogenesis and pedology, I didn't explain. You at least try. Then regur, I didn't explain that one, but I said about the black soil, it is already there. Laterite, I explained, it's a Latin word letter. For letter, we are getting the word brick. In a detailed way given, you try to find out exact one. Leaching, little bit I said. And these three words, their meaning you have to find one. Contour plowing, strip cropping and terracing,
or you can write terrace farming. And the last one, planting of shelter bills. Next homework, distinguish between them. At least you try to write 2 points if possible. Your first difference is transported soil and residual soil, which also known ex situ and in situ. Means transported soil is also known or also called ex situ soil. It is also called in situ one. So first you try to write the difference. Then I will say about it. Then a very easy two I have given. Alluvial soil of North India and South India. Then I told Wangar and Khadar. Also given in the book, you first try to prepare that one. Now I have given some question from our exercise part. You go to that one, that page where exercise many questions given. I want to see the answer in your copy, particular these numbers. 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 26, 28. This number I want to see. I think total 7 questions are there. So I want to see the answer of these 7 questions. And 2 give reasons I have given related to black soil. 1. Black soil is known for its self-ploughing quality. You have to write the reason why. Next, black soil needs to be filled after, tilled after the first rain. Why? These 2 give reasons. So these answers I want to see in your copy with that table. So now this chapter 3, soil has done. Thank you. We will meet again.